Hi, I'm Sanjay Nagchowdhury, Development Lead for the IBM AppConnect Enterprise team. In this video, I will demonstrate how to create a vault in AppConnect Enterprise version 11, Fixed Pack 6, and then store credentials in it. These credentials are then used by a flow to access a database using JDBC. I will be using an independent integration server and I'll use the same flow and policy that I used in an earlier video which demonstrated how to use policy and policy overrides. New in AppConnect Enterprise version 11 Fixed Pack 6 is a vault which uses symmetric encryption to encrypt and decrypt data records that are stored in the vault. AES 256-bit encryption is used for encrypting the data in the vault. The vault is accessed using a vault key. A new command called mqsivault is provided, which allows you to create or destroy a vault in a work directory that is used by an integration server. If a vault has been created in the work directory, then the vault key must be specified when starting the integration server. The vault key can be stored in a .mqsivault.rc file, which can be used instead of specifying the vault key as a parameter value for a command. Having created the vault, you can use it to store data in it, which will be encrypted in the vault. In version 11, Fixed Pack 6, we have provided a new command called mqsicredentials, which allows you to store credentials in the vault. The mqsicredentials command can be used as an alternative to mqsisetdbparms. The credentials will be encrypted in the vault and can be used by the integration server to access external resources like databases. You must specify the vault key when using the mqsicredentials command. You can create, report, update, and delete credentials while the integration server is stopped. You can create and report credentials while the integration server is running. I have a flow running on a Mac which is accessing a DB2 database running on Windows. I am accessing data from the database using a Java Compute Node and a JDBC provider policy. The credential is referenced in the JDBC provider policy for accessing the database. I can create a work directory using mqsi create workdir. This creates four subdirectories and a server.conf.yaml. Let's start by creating a vault in the work directory using mqsi vault and specifying a vault key. In this case, the vault key is my vault key. If I try and start the integration server without specifying the vault key, an error is reported. If I specify the vault key, then the integration server starts up. I can connect to the integration server from the toolkit. If I deploy the policy project and deploy the application using the flow exerciser, I can put a message through the flow. However, an exception is caught and propagated from the catch terminal of the input node. The exception has occurred as the credentials had not been defined in the vault, so the flow could not connect to the database and access the data. I can create the credentials in the vault while the integration server is started or stopped using the mqsi credentials command. When using the mqsi credentials command, I must specify the work directory location, a credential name, and credential type. Having created the credentials, I can confirm that they are stored in the vault using the encrypted credentials command or using the web UI. Note that passwords are not shown on either the command line or in the web UI. If I now put a second message through the same flow, I can now see that the data has been accessed from the database using the credentials that were stored in the vault. Notice that I did not need to restart the integration server for the changes to take effect. I also didn't need to redeploy the flow or restart the flow. The credentials were accessed from the vault on the next message through the flow in this example. In this video, I have shown how to configure a vault in an integration server and use it to store credentials in an encrypted form. A vault key must be supplied for the integration server to access the vault. The vault key can be supplied in different ways. The mqsi credentials command can be used as an alternative to mqsi setdbpalms.